点点点点点点点点点。
What is up, people? It's me, the Negrolorian, and I am here about to play RoboCop, Rogue City. I almost said Rogue Nation. This is not a Mission Impossible game. Anyways, I've been really excited for this game. Anybody that knows me knows that freaking movies are a big part of my life, my personality, and RoboCop is one of my favorites. And when I saw they were doing a RoboCop game, I had to play this because I really love the RoboCop series. The first two specifically. You know, the ultra-violent cyberpunk aesthetic, the political commentary, you know, the satirical elements, poking fun at fucking consumerism. It's just a great, great series overall. Y'all remember the RoboCop cartoon? There was a RoboCop cartoon. Matter of fact, hold on, y'all. Hold on. Just so y'all know, I'm not playing about my love for the RoboCop series. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on.
Bro, look at this.
Bro. We got the RoboCop movie poster, bro. It's right outside my door. First thing you see when you step out this room, you got Alex Murphy in your face. Part man, part machine, all cop. But yeah, I've been really excited to play this game, man. I played the demo on Steam a while back when they released it. Cause I was kind of worried how this game was going to play, to be real. But this game plays exactly the way it's supposed to play, bro. RoboCop isn't, he's not Gray Fox. He's not the cyborg ninja. You know, he's a tank. He slowly moves around and, you know, pops off headshots. And that's exactly how this game plays. So I was excited. I'm excited to get into this. So let's do it. Let's do it. There it is. There it is. This game was also made by the same developers, the same guys that did the Terminator game. I think it was called Resistance. I did play that. It was a cool game. It was a cool game. Got the platinum for it, you know. But this right here, this is what I've been waiting for. RoboCop is also like, the series is probably like one of the most quotable series ever. Normal, hard, extreme, bro. Are there difficulty trophies? Because, hold on. There it is. All right, I'm done, y'all. I'm done. We're doing normal.
You give us 3 minutes.
What was that?
Good evening. I'm Casey Wong. A military submarine that went missing over 3 years ago has suddenly reappeared in the Baltic Sea. Confused seamen mistakenly opened fire on the last Lapland reservation, killing 12. Thankfully, our homesick sailors are back on U.S. soil. Welcome back, boys. In local news, a new crime wave that is sweeping Detroit has already claimed the lives of 21 police officers. Here's a statement from the head.
Oh yeah, this game takes place between RoboCop 2 and 3, I believe. So there's no Kane, you know. Kane's dead already.
...of OCP, Omni Consumer Products, that's funding and running the Detroit Police Department.
Old Detroit has a cancer. And that cancer is crime.
Old man.
It must be cut out, and OCP holds the scalpel.
According to our sources, the attacks were aimed at catching the attention of a man whose identity remains unknown. This dangerous new guy in town seems to have his eye on doing business in Old Detroit.
Your filthy hands off me.
Shut up. I'm sorry. There seems to be a
disturbance? I'm a big fan. Now move! Don't adjust your television sets. Your regularly scheduled program will be back shortly. Now, this message goes out to the new guy in town. It seems that you're looking to spend some money in this great city of ours. I'm here to tell you that the Torchheads are open for business. You may have heard of us as the number one supplier of Nuke in old Detroit.
Nuke.
The most potent, addictive drug available in front of every convenience store, school, or library near you. But that's not all we're capable of.
It's so crazy that we're playing a RoboCop game in 2023.
Let's get you up here.
You love to see it.
We'll get Officer Howard to illustrate the point. You see, Officer Howard made a drug bust that cost us a lot of money. We want to reward this dutiful officer with a performance bonus. A lifetime supply of Nuke.
Nah, I'm good. I don't need that.
You're gonna have the time of your life. There you go. Enjoy.
That man went out instantly, bro. He on cloud 11.
Capable of doing whatever you need done in our city. So what is it, huh? Arson, smuggling, drug dealing, good old-fashioned murder. We do it all. You've got the money. We've got the power. So let's talk.
Looks like a job for Alex Murphy. I can definitely see the difference between the PS5 version and the PC version, obviously. But this still looks really good. Textures are taking a while to load in, but, you know.
Kitty!
Judgment Day is here!
Those steps.
Hey, handsome, we're here for the show. Go get him, Robo.
Y'all hear them footsteps? You know it's about to go down, bruh. If you're a criminal and you hear a loud stomping like this, you might as well just give up.
I wouldn't bother. I already ran the plates.
You should know by now when it comes to
this game. Still looks good. I'm surprised. Like, I think this is a smaller team, if I'm not mistaken. Report to the lieutenant. Alright, we're at the news station. Let me fight an Ed 209, please. At some point. You already know it. That's gonna happen, bruh.
We can't wait any longer. Those trigger happy maniacs have a ton of hostages. But sir.
And they brought, I didn't even mention that. They brought Peter Weller back, bruh. The voice of this game.
Goddamn OCP tells us to stand down till SWAT arrives. That's our situation.
Looks like I'm on the way out.
Not so fast, buddy.
Lewis!
Who do you think is gonna clean up this place? I'm not letting
they'll
you off
fix
that
you.
Easily.
You sound just like my wife.
If that's the case, let's get you patched up. We wouldn't want to get on her bad side. Press here. Medic!
Help him out, help him out.
Partner.
Lewis.
The hell is going on up there?
Sorry, dude! The police want us to release the hostages! So no hard feelings!
Damn.
Hey! You can't go in yet! We need to wait for the reinforcements!
Reinforcements have arrived.
I knew you'd say something like that.
We need to find another way. It is too dangerous to cross.
For me. But you can take the heat. Go, I'll figure something out. Besides, you can
the music, bruh.
Go on.
This is basically the demo right here, but I didn't play the whole demo because I didn't want to be spoiled too much.
Is it gold?
It was taken off someone famous. Just look at
him. I think the demo was pretty lengthy.
I play like 30 minutes.
Guys, we've got company. Anyone expecting a silver freak?
Drop it, scum.
Let's get it. Oh, this is weird. Okay. Not the theme song going off. L2 to investigate individuals or objects. Oh, can't throw it back. Doing, bro? Yes, sir. The elevator, Murphy. Elevator.
Worried about the weight limit?
Lewis, you're here.
We need to get these elevators back online. The service box is in the basement.
Let me.
I doubt you had time between all the heroics, but I got a key card from the janitor. It's good to do some real street work from time to time, you know? After you.
Thank you, Lois.
They sabotage the elevators and staircase too. They obviously don't want to be disturbed.
What's this? Stolen wallet? Crime evidence plus 25?
That graffiti is fresh.
I bet some of those idiots are still here.
Yeah, I already know how to heal myself. You guys already told me. OCP recovery charge. That's it? Alright.
We cannot let him pass!
Okay, Gandalf. Bro, I shot him in the head. How'd he take that?
I will keep them coming.
What a warm welcome, don't you think?
I don't see anything to pick up. Wait, never mind. Nuke. We got some contraband. Alright, good shot. Good shot, Lewis. Fake money. Let me pick up one of these other weapons. Micro SMG. Oh, this motherfucker overdosed on that nuke. Oh, I already got enough of these. Fisher. Oh, you scared me, bruh. Yes. Your move, creep. Incriminating evidence. Stolen. What are a lot of stolen wallets in here? Oh, so you're missing all the evidence. All the contraband. I wonder how the collectibles are like in this game to be real. What would it be? Oh, I can grab him? Get over here. Get him, Lois. Wait, where's the SMG? Did I run out of ammo? Do I have to like pick up the ammo? I can't just walk over it. I'm gonna have to get used to that. Let's try this out. Let's try the assault rifle, the AR. Hey, why don't you check it out? All right, give me a second. You're not really checking your surroundings. I can barely talk right now, bro. That's how excited I am to play this. Restore power. Let's get it. Objects investigation. You can use Robocop vision to investigate objects or people to find clues. Investigatable objects are marked with a question mark. Press L2 while looking at the question mark to investigate them.
I am detecting a short circuit. We need to isolate the cables.
That's another good movie. Just for that. Short circuit. Taeyeon, y'all gonna do a short circuit game next? Collect as much input as possible. Fire.
You are very resourceful.
Thanks, but
not Taeyeon. Who's Taeyeon, bruh? I had to look at the game case. Like, is that their name?
They're holding everyone in the studio.
Is it? I don't know. Shit. It is Taeyeon. Let's look.
In blue finally decided to join our glamorous show. I'm afraid you're too late for my autograph.
Chopper's ready.
I've gotta go, but the party goes on. Guys, Make sure you provide all our guests with a decent amount of amusement, so don't skimp on the nuke. See ya.
Oh, he sees him. That was cool.
We need to be quick before they kill.
I don't remember that.
I know that look, Murphy. You saw something, didn't you?
We are here to enforce the law, Lewis. Let us stay focused.
Right.
Wow.
Just keep in mind that I'm here if you need me, partner.
He's like, that's the old me.
Slime bags detected.
Just look at that, boys! The police dog and its bitch!
Not sure which one is which.
You're gonna take that back.
Let me grab one of these TVs. I'ma throw it at a dirt bag. I didn't miss anything. I heard a popo. Oh, here we go. More nuke. Definitely need that. Fake ID, stolen handbag. Oh. Oh, yes. Incriminating documents. Bruh, this music got me feeling some kind of way. I might have to pop the old Blu-ray in tonight. Zip this up. Did I shoot him in the nuts? Tell you what, that assault rifle wasn't doing shit for me. Where's the other guy? Yeah, let me grab another monitor, bro. Hold on. Gotta pick up that nuke. Incriminating documents. Nah, but real talk, y'all. I know I'm kind of glazing RoboCop, but I really do love these movies. Goodbye. Homeboy survived a grenade blast. Oh, let me repair, bruh. Get out of here. Make me. Oh, hold on. Strong antidepressants. I can't pick these up. Alright, they're just to scan. Are you sure? We shall proceed. Punk power.
We cannot let him pass.
They sound like posers. Alright. Locked? Man, I'm RoboCop. Let me bust this motherfucker up. When you face criminals who have taken hostages, you have only a few seconds to eliminate the threat and protect the innocent. Use your extraordinary reflexes to meet this challenge. I remember doing this and couldn't tell who... Nah, I need that back, bruh. Cause it wasn't even letting me shoot right there. It's all good. We can't save them all.
This lady really needs to see a doctor.
Murphy, these people need help. Why don't you go ahead? I'll stay with them.
Right.
This is Lewis. We have rescued three hostages. One with a gunshot wound to the abdomen.
They even got the turds down, bruh. That motherfucker here is always staying ahead, bruh. Always facing forward. Okay, I thought I was at maximum. Alright. Who wants it? I'm pretty sure I didn't shoot that grenade. Bro, I was stuck on that box. Or whatever, the ladder was in my way. It didn't want me to be great. I'll take that though. Bro, you gotta be kidding me. I ain't worried about y'all. Definitely need that. What else I'm realizing is the lock-on in the demo was way more... It was kind of cheap. They fixed it a little bit, I'm not gonna lie. It was like you locked on like right on their head. It was just easy picking. What happened to the... Hello? I can do that too. You know, there's probably an upgrade for the lock-on. I should have got him. Still alive, you can't tell in this game. The one guy survived that grenade earlier. Oh, I ain't forgot about you over here. Is he over here? Where is he? What was that? Did I level up? I need some more charges. Okay, we're good. For sure. For sure. Family.
It's a surprise. Little man, have you washed your hands?
Oh, it's because the set. The set's making him think of his home.
Do I really have to? I wasn't playing in the dirt.
I doubt there's anything to pick up here.
Of course
but.
You do. No more discussion. Darn.
What about Dad?
Can I have some pop?
That was weird.
The color of this dress. I'm not sure if I like the pattern. James really looks up to you. He said in school that he wants to be a police officer just like his dad.
Son. I don't know if you want to be a police officer. Not in Detroit, at least. Here we go. Look, it's not shooting. It's literally not shooting. There, definitely need to fix that, my guys. How can I save the hostages if the gun's not shooting? It only does it in that slow-mo part, though. Like, when you go through the doors, when you breach the doors.
No sudden moves, cop! I'm not dying here! Get me another one of those choppers, like the one that took Soot! You hear me?
You work so hard, honey. Why don't you take some leave? We all could use a little break from this reality, don't you think?
Wakey wakey! I'm talking to you, Shiny! Stand back from that door, or I'll shoot her! I swear to Nuke!
I don't know what I would do if I ever lost you.
You've got 3 seconds! 3!
Our family is the only thing I need to be happy.
2! Are you King Dev?
Trust me, we will stay like this forever.
1! Last chance, weirdo!
I love you so much, Alex. You okay there, Murphy?
I'm fine.
What does it want? Get it away from me!
I am sorry.
Can you see? It's unstable!
Ma'am, please, calm down. It's been a very tough evening, and I assure you that everyone wants to be back home with their families. For some of us, the night has just begun.
Hey. Night has just begun. So is this entire game going to take place in one night? That'd be kind of crazy. Here's the chief.
I can pay my bail now. Cash? No problem. Do you take singles?
Get back in line.
They're here.
Get back in line. She said, do you take singles? Homegirl, foolish.
Good job, Murphy.
I think you're forgetting someone.
Officer Lewis, you were remarkable.
Soot ran off with his tail between his legs.
Would have been nice if we caught him, though.
All right, all right. Are you done with this circle jerk, huh? Good. We've got a problem.
The malfunction caught on camera provokes a question. Can we put our safety into the hands of a machine? Especially one as unreliable as RoboCop. We asked Max Becker, the head of security concepts at OCP.
Now quiet!
We would never put a defective product on the streets. That's not what we do.
We all saw it hesitate in a life and death situation. Why? Does it really know right from wrong?
Listen, I would trust this guy with my kids. I mean, if I had any.
It's
just an isolated glitch. Thank you.
Mr. Becker, I've got more questions.
I just want to snap her little neck.
Chill, bruh. It's not that deep.
She's got a point. This was not an isolated incident. It's a pattern. A pattern that the old man wants examined and fixed. Time to see what's hiding in that metal head of yours.
We know what's in Murphy's head. It's what's in yours that worries us.
Push me.
Tell him, Lewis.
You might just find out.
Tell him.
You, follow me.
Isolated.
And Lewis, I need your report on the TV station incident. On the double.
On it, Sarge.
Go to the holding cell. Alright, I wanted to look around the station, but we'll do this first. We'll play your game. Don't hold your breath. OCP isn't looking to spend a dime on our equipment. My visor's a little banged up.
My favorite walking, talking law enforcement machine. Okay, let's get on with it. Why don't you take a seat for me? That's a nasty scar. I'd like to see the other guy. Am I right?
You do not. Trust me.
Don't mind me. I'll just get this off.
So, here's the deal, Robo. The old man is not happy with your performance. Instead of sending you to the scrapyard, as I suggested, he wants to fix you. Hey, pretty boy. You sure know how to make an impression on the ladies.
Is she new here?
Doesn't
like
it hurt him?
Hurt. Lady, he's a machine. He's legally dead. We can do whatever we want with him.
No, madam. It does not hurt me physically.
So we're going to equip you with a little monitoring chip. It will do a real-time check of your systems so we can get to the bottom of what the hell is wrong with you. From now on, your performance will be monitored and graded. So, better be on your best behavior, huh?
The chip is in. Let's
see. Yes,
what we
sir.
Have here.
It's in. Stop it. Stop it, sir. All main objectives completed. Secondary objectives?
None.
Couldn't save any of the hostages because the game was holding me, but you know, hopefully that gets fixed soon. Each time you achieve a new level, you receive a skill point that can be used to develop your skills. Developing skills allow you to increase efficiency, obtain unique perks, and unlock favorable dialogue options. We got 3 skill points. Combat, armor, vitality, engineering, focus. Scanning. Ah. Doubles earn public trust points. Let's do okay, that adds 5% bonus weapon damage, armor, and then we could do shield. You can use fuse boxes to recover up to 50% of your health and increases the maximum OCP recovery charges to 4. So every tier, it goes up 1. The last tier, 75% of your health gradually recovers over time.
Well, I can already see some unwanted activity in your hippocampus. We'll have to keep an eye on it. Other than that, everything seems to be installed correctly. To be sure, let's make a simple test to check that all circuits are in order. What are your prime directives?
Serve the public trust. Protect the innocent. Uphold the law.
Okay, nothing disturbed. However, like with any new upgrade, I recommend visiting the range to check if you need calibration.
Is that everything?
Actually, no. Doctor?
Oh, yes, sorry. My name is Dr. Olivia Blanche. I'm a police psychologist. I specialize in dealing with police officers suffering from emotional trauma.
Emotional trauma? Might as well talk to the microwave. It hasn't been working properly either.
OCP wanted to see if you'd be willing to have a talk with me as part of your evaluation. I noticed that a great deal of care has been put into making sure that your mechanical components work.
Olivia Blanche.
However, one aspect of your composition that has been severely neglected is your human side, your brain.
I agree. If it was up to me, I'd remove it altogether. What do you think, Doctor? Would save us a lot of hassle.
I don't mind the hassle. So what do you say, officer? Is that possibly something that could be of interest to you?
I am not sure.
Robo, Reed wants everyone in the briefing room in 5. It's about the new guy.
New guy?
Excuse me, Dr. Blanche, but I am needed elsewhere.
But we...
Oh, she has a prosthetic. I just noticed that.
Well, can't say we didn't try. Everyone get back to whatever the fuck you usually do around here.
Alright, I saw some little side missions pop up while I was walking to this place. Locked and loaded. Let's track it.
Tell you, it was crazy in that TV station. Good job you had Murphy in with you. You bet. Without him, we'd all be goners.
What seems to be the problem?
My damn locker won't open. Can you try?
Can I try?
Wait, what is all this shit doing in my locker?
I wanted you to be safe out there.
Bro, imagine...
Yeah, you guys, very good.
And your colleagues just filling your locker up with freaking smoke grenades. Like, bro, we fighting. That has to be a safety hazard, right?
Murphy, I heard you're scheduled for calibration. Step right up and press the button when you're ready.
Don't mind if I do.
Passing grade. Wouldn't be a problem to you.
Nothing but headshots.
50. Wanna try to break the record?
missed. Well, that's not happening.
Good job. I'll let the eggheads know that you're good to go. See you in the briefing room.
Dang, 50 is a record, man. No wonder why crime is so high in Detroit, bruh. My name's not Cecil, but alright.
Hi, Murphy.
Hey.
There is no way. Murphy, would you give me a hand?
Who was that? Who was calling me? Oh, it was old girl right here. Estevez.
I can deal with blood, guts, but puke is a no-go for me. I'll be a sport and move his ass to the drunk tank.
What about guts and ass and shit?
And extra protection, so you shouldn't mind.
All right.
Just take him downstairs. I owe you one, Murphy. Oh no, the smell is following you. I'm gonna be sick.
You've had one too many, sir.
I don't remember getting on a roller coaster.
I want to go here.
Look who's back home. Just toss him in one of the empty cells.
Finally home.
Sleep tight.
All right, we can't close the cell.
Murphy, could you please help me out here?
Hey, everybody need help, huh? God damn, I gotta do it all.
Seems to be the problem, officer.
Reed is in the briefing room, and I have my hands full. There are so many complaints filing in that I can't keep up. It's getting crazy in here. Could you open up another line and help me?
I am here to serve the public trust.
Take the spot on the podium. You're a lifesaver, Robo.
Open a new line.
This line is open. Please form an orderly queue.
Officer, I have a problem. My neighbors are hostile toward me. I think it's because they're jealous of my new dog. Why would they get so worked up every time I take him for a walk?
What is his name?
He has a beautiful red coat, so I call him Fire. He likes to hide, so sometimes I have to yell, Fire! Fire! To find him. Anyway, can you do something about my neighbors?
You know what? They're probably pissed because you keep yelling fire, and these motherfuckers keep thinking their shit's about to burn down. You disrupt public order? I'm not gonna do them like that.
No, but I will let you off with a warning.
That's fine. I don't mind paying the price for having the cutest dog in all of Detroit.
Next, please.
I got something for you, officer. I know where you can find a wanted criminal. That poster over there says there's a reward for that information. And I want it.
I want details.
Are you blind? I'm the guy from that poster, so here I am. Now, give me the money.
Bruh.
I will have to.
Your eyes are bloodshot red.
I still get the reward.
Can you come in, turning yourself in? You can hope for a reduced sentence.
You can hope for a reduced sentence.
That's not the reward I was hoping for, but I'll take it. It'd be good to get back to jail. Life as a free man can be tiring.
Take him away.
Hey, I know that's how it's like for a lot of guys, a lot of people.
Officer,
unfortunately.
I would like to report my son missing.
How old is he?
He's 24, but he's never been gone for so long without letting me know.
How long has it been?
Just over 2 days now.
We do not consider an adult missing within 72 hours.
Oh, please, I'm begging you. Something's not right. You really need to find him.
Come back in 24 hours. Provide me with details.
What is his name and address?
George Elkins, 7706 Orchard Avenue.
Let me check. Your son was found dead.
Wow.
Hours ago.
What? Oh, no.
Thanks for the help, Murphy.
Bro, that was three people, bruh. But hey, glad to help. Incident report. Type of incident, missing body. Person reporting, Nancy McGuire. Officer filing report, Michael Briggs. Description of event. Miss McGuire's husband's body has gone missing during transport to Hawthorne's funeral home. Moreover, there is no information on such delivery in the funeral home's records. Additional comments? It's a third report on a missing cadaver this week. We need to take a look into it. For sure. I'm pretty sure we're gonna get into that.
It's no secret. The crime has been on the rise ever since what the media has named the new guy in town showed up in the city. The word on the street is that he wants to spend a lot of money in old Detroit, and that has made every gang in the city start advertising their services. We need to find him before things get out of control.
Where do we look?
Our best bet is to see if he made contact with the Torchheads. Robo, I want you to start by checking the arcade downtown. It's become a high-activity area for punks.
For sure.
Understood.
Everyone else, keep your eyes open. Any questions?
Any word on Briggs?
What happened to Briggs?
He's been missing since yesterday.
Shit.
Officer Briggs remains missing. That's over 24 hours since he's been in contact with anyone here.
Are the two cases connected?
No reason to assume so. But if anyone finds Briggs' informant, we might learn something new. All right, now get out there.
All right, let's get to it.
I need to write this report, and there's something else I need to do first.
I wonder what that is. You have a hot date, Lewis? There's my ride.
Cruiser's ready for you, Robo. Go get him.
Thank you. We at the arcade. It was called Arcade Town.
City, didn't you? It'd be easier to burn it all to the ground. Believe me, just burn it all.
Kitty.
If this was Cyberpunk, I'd be able to pet it.
Ask about Suit's whereabouts? Oh yeah, Suit's that punk-ass torch head, dude. Ronnie's grocery.
Could you please keep the noise down? You're scaring off my customers.
Can't hear you. Music's too loud.
Good evening. Are those two men bothering you?
First, they harass my customers.
Then they threatened to burn down my shop. You need to do something about it, officer.
Oh, don't worry, we're on it.
Cop. Can't we have a little bit of fun? We did nothing wrong.
I can help turn off the radio. There's also nothing wrong with breaking criminal bones. The music is too loud.
Your volume control seems to be broken.
Leave it! That's brand new! I've only stolen...
Yeah, that's right! Get your asses out of here!
Thanks, officer.
Store clerk will no longer be harassed? I would hope not. Wow. This is actually a pretty decent sized area.
Okay.
So I wonder if I could, if I just like search around this area, I could find shit going down. Okay, Mahershala Ali. All right, let me just follow the objective. Psych. Oh, did you look at that? You look at that. Okay, the arcade's down there, so we're gonna go this way naturally.
I always wanted to be a cop. I even applied to the academy, but it turns out that extensive criminal history and drug addiction prevent you getting in.
Yeah, that'll do it, my guy, Bay. Don't give up on your dreams. And stay out of trouble.
Oh, this is a nice little park.
Something's coming. I can feel it. How?
You're good. Can I go over here? Don't give me big open areas like this, bro, because I'm going to want to look around. Has to be something, right? Okay, so keep a lookout for crates. Gotcha. I need to keep that in mind. I need to take a mental note. That does not sound appealing.
Help! This rascal was trying to steal my cart. Look what he's done!
Have I just wrecked your life savings? Tough shit, stinker.
Antisocial behavior towards a fellow citizen can be classified as a crime. You can go, but remember that mistreating another member of society is like singing off-key. It disrupts harmony.
Harmony, my ass!
I can't believe you're letting him go! If that's how you operate, you might as well jump in my cart with the rest of the scrap!
You just knocked your cart over, my guy. I mean, I can help you pick it up if you want. Shit. Pick it up with my higher-ups, motherfucker. Issuing tickets. As a police officer, you can issue tickets for misdemeanors like public drinking and disorderly conduct of traffic violations. Hold L2 to activate roll cop vision. Okay. Hazardous oil spillage.
One that likes swimming in oil surely must be swimming in money.
All right. One skill point.
Mike was driving and we heard what we thought was a blown tire, but it was just a gunshot.
Oh, I found a quest. Who killed Casey? Carmel? That's Carmel, not, you know, people be saying caramel like Carmel.
He's my favorite TV star.
Thanks to you, Kurt's finally had a reason to watch something other than the fast food channel.
When it comes to cleaning criminal scum from the city, I'm even better live. Can you tell me what happened here?
Nasty murder. The victim is a white female, mid-20s, identified as Casey Carmel. Had a history of petty crime and prostitution, but believe it or not, that's her real name.
Any leads?
The case is closed. OCP won't spend a single dime on the murder of a prostitute.
Cost optimization. Fancy name for we don't give a shit about poor people.
So if you were to look around the crime scene, you would potentially be exposing OCP to extra costs.
If you want to do that, be our guest.
Do you have any thoughts about that murder?
I'd bet the girl was killed somewhere else, and the body was only dumped here. And we got the tire tracks, drag marks. If we find a car that matches, we'll find our perp. Yeah, I guess the perp had his hands covered in some green-blue guacamole-ish goo. The body's covered in them.
Why does it always come back to food with you? Anyway, we need to do a proper analysis.
Is that homeless man considered a suspect?
Nah, we know the guy. You can rule him out.
The guy's a loon, a mental patient. He thinks that aliens dumped the body here.
Talk to him if you want. Just prepare to hear a tall tale about green people.
Green people, and you said green goo was she was covered in, right?
The best way to cut the costs of policing is to cut the criminals down.
Tell me about it. I didn't join the force to pick up dead bodies off the street.
Yeah, but what can we do?
I will look around. We must bring the murderer to justice.
All right, let's have a look. RoboCop vision. Activate RoboCop vision by pressing L2 to highlight enemies and important objects in the environment. You can also investigate those objects or use them in combat. All right.
Somebody dumped her a few feet from here. The blood traces on the ground indicate she was dragged.
Okay, there's...
Her heels had to touch the ground when the body was dragged.
Yeah, her feet's bloody. Someone bash her head in?
Nasty wound. Looks like she was hit with a blunt object, possibly a hammer.
And the markings right here.
That's this green-blue shit under her arm. No idea what it might be, but there is more of it around.
All right.
Yeah, probably belonged to our victim. Let's try to find other clues.
Did it belong? Is she missing a shoe? She sure was. Yeah, the chimney pipes are relevant to the case. Oh, the tire marks.
Custom extended wheelbase. Have you seen a vehicle like this around?
Nah. But that narrows it down significantly. Good catch, Robo.
Blood type AB. Question the witness. Okay, so that was the whole area. Okay, cool. Alright, let's talk to the homeless guy. He saw aliens.
I can help you find the guy who dumped the body here. I saw him, but you must accept the truth.
Tell me what you know.
It's as simple as it gets. Aliens did it.
Aliens?
I've been investigating them for years. They send rats to spy on me. They don't want me to show you this list. It's a list of aliens living in Detroit. All 37,617 of them. The murderer included.
Most likely a van with a custom extended wheelbase. Does your list contain any information on such a vehicle?
Jackpot! I've got a guy with a van that matches your description. I don't know his ID, but I know where you can find him. A film set near the courthouse.
Ah!
They're showing a TV commercial and it's run by aliens, so it all makes sense.
I know the place.
Casey must have discovered something there, and they got her. That must have been what's happened.
What is the purpose of your list? Well, it's for aliens, obviously, but why have a list?
It's my tool to spread the truth. I update it every month and add it to my newsletter. You should read it. It's free.
How do you determine who's an alien?
You wouldn't see on TV.
Like what?
Take the moon landing, for example.
Oh, here we go.
Didn't happen. Why? Because the moon doesn't exist. First time hearing about it? That's why you need my newsletter.
Tell me about the filming set.
Why do you think that aliens run the set?
Who do you think runs the advertising business?
Run the set, huh, Mercy?
They're stuffing commercials with subliminal messages. They use additional film frames with commands to make us obey. Don't you know what happens to those who watch TV?
Don't tell me this is a They Live, Bro, this is a They Live callback. He has the shades on and everything. I'm just now... Okay! Alright!
Why do you think that aliens are involved?
I saw the guy who dumped the body here. I saw his skin. It was green and glowing like those toy dinosaurs that children play with and years later develop serious diseases from.
All right, let's get out of here. Enough of this guy.
I will verify your statement. Nevertheless, I recommend you consult a psychiatrist at the earliest possible time. Now. The set.
Gain access to the film set. The guy said we need a warrant earlier, right? They legit put a They Live callback or whatever Easter egg in there. That was dope. Movie heads will get it.
Here? They're shooting a TV commercial for Sunblock 5000.
Night does not seem an appropriate time for such practice.
Yeah. They ran into some problems, and it's running later than expected.
I swear, we're staying here until we finish, or you're doing it without me!
Jerry, don't you think you're being unreasonable?
You better find us another understudy so we can get this over with!
Why does he look like that?
Hey man, we don't want to hinder the work of law enforcement.
She looks like Linda Hamilton. Get out of my way, bozo! Sarah Connor?
I have reason to believe that someone from your crew is involved in a crime. We found a green-blue substance like your sunblock at the crime scene. The suspect was driving a van with a custom extended wheelbase.
We use a lot of different vans, but I would know if they're the type you're looking for.
In that case, I would like to look around.
Actually, you could be of some use to me, too.
I have a problem here, and its name is Jerry. Jerry Jenkins. I need a reason to cancel his contract, and I think you could find one for me.
That does not sound like a task.
Yeah.
Police officer.
Ah, but it could be, though. I'm sure he's guilty of something. You just have to find out what it is. I can give you access to anything without a warrant.
I only carry out the request of justice.
I believe that. Dig deep. I bet Mr. Bigshot doesn't have a clear conscience. Start with the computer. There's a list of vehicles allowed to park on set there. But look for something on Jenkins, too.
For sure.
Nope, it's the same, tracks. What is this? Same goo? That matches the one on the victim's body. And then we can talk to this guy, right? Lead actor matches the suspect's description. Interesting. Excuse me. This is the computer she wants us to access. Got you. Nikki Troy. Night shooting preparation. Don't worry, Tess. I'll handle everything, but you must know the crew is afraid of working at nighttime. Maybe we should arrange more bodyguards? Cars allowed to park on set. Okay, this is probably what we need to look at. Alright. Cars allowed to park on set. Updated delivery yesterday, 12:43. One additional van outside the team. Okay, so there's five vehicles here, plus a... I didn't even, Teresa, I'm sorry to hear you've encountered difficulties working with Jerry. Please excuse him. He's in a bad mood. You know how sensitive an artist he is. Fortunately, I've been his agent long enough to know what would help. The company of a nice, beautiful girl. Don't worry, I'll arrange everything myself. Just charge this to the client's account. Wow, so how convenient. This motherfucker killed the prostitute. They brought a prostitute in for him. And it went bad. At least that's what it looks like. Right.
The evidence I have gathered shows that you are connected to the investigation that I am conducting.
So what?
The perpetrator was someone with skin that seemed to be covered with sunblock. I saw the storyboard. You fit the description.
Nice try, but I won't even touch that toxic goo. I've got it in the contract. I use body doubles for all the shots where I'm supposedly covered with it. Wait, that bitch sent you after me, didn't she? She's looking for a way to screw me over and hide her incompetence. You want to investigate something, then ask her about the guy she hired as the understudy. His face looks like a walking mugshot. On top of that, I bet he's the one who stole my ring. See what she has to say about him, pal.
No, I want to... Okay, I can only pick one object there. I mean, yeah, okay. Cool.
I spoke with Jenkins. He mentioned that you hired a criminal. This individual may be the perpetrator I am looking for.
You mean the understudy? Did Jenkins tell you that I hired him? He was the one who recommended him for the job. Don't believe me? Check the camera footage to see what good friends they are.
Where is the understudy now?
I have no idea. And that's the whole point. We can't keep shooting because he's disappeared. I hope the guy's in the hospital or worse, because if he's not, I'll kill him myself. It's a joke, of course. You understand jokes, don't you?
That's very telling.
Why did you hire the understudy?
Jenkins' contract says he will not use sunblock, and none of the professional understudies wanted to do it either. They all say it's toxic. So I had no choice. Jenkins brought a guy and said he could do the job.
Show me the footage.
Check the camera footage.
Who are you, pal?
Your agent sent me. Special services.
Why does he sound like that?
Man, I've got a place. Of course, Mr. Jenkins, I'll take...
Take it and get lost! The smell of hard-boiled eggs mixing with this green shit makes me want to puke. Looking at your face doesn't help either. You. You mentioned something about special services.
Only the best in Detroit.
I find that hard to believe.
I've got just the girl for you. Her name's Casey. She's...
No names.
Okay, so the understudy recommended Casey.
Your understudy offered you the services of a prostitute. She was likely the prostitute who was killed.
People offer me things all the time, but that doesn't mean I accept every one of them.
Withholding information about illegal activity is also a crime.
Ha! If that's the case, I wouldn't be the only criminal in this goddamn business. You know what? Now that I think about it, why shouldn't I help the law enforcement of this here beautiful city?
Where can I find the understudy?
He works at a gas station nearby. But I don't think that's his main source of income.
I am not done with you yet. Do not leave the city.
All right, I have to go around. Gain access to the gas station. I mean, it shouldn't be too hard to do. It's a gas station. We still have to go to the arcade, bruh. Car is that? Smears of sunblock.
Who's there? You have to help me, man. This shit is burning my skin.
The fuck?
Sunblock is the least of your worries.
Look, I know why you're here, but I'm innocent! I swear!
You are being detained in connection with the murder of Casey Carmel. If you require medical attention, it will be given to you.
I didn't do it! Jenkins killed her! Jerry Jenkins, the guy from TV! You have to believe me!
You will make your statement at the station.
And you'll let Jenkins walk free! He's the one who killed Casey! They met here yesterday!
Casey's body was covered in sunblock. The evidence points to you.
I arranged the meeting, I admit, but I was gone when this happened. When I came back, she was already dead, and I decided to get rid of the body. Jenkins is the only one who could have done it.
You know what? They did say the body was moved. But bruh, you're still in trouble. Why would you move the body? What the fuck?
Why did you not go to the police?
What would I say? That a famous celebrity killed a street prostitute in the back of my gas station? That's a bit much even for this city.
Dumping that woman's body in a dumpster seemed like a better idea to you.
It's not my fault that people would rather believe a guy from TV over me.
Why would Jenkins kill that woman?
I don't know. I wasn't there.
Are you stalling?
She may have mentioned something about wanting to blackmail Jenkins, but I knocked the idea out of her head. At least I think I did.
Why would Jenkins be meeting a prostitute here when there is a motel across the street?
His agent got a hold of me and told me that the guy values his privacy. The money was good, and I was able to provide him with a discreet option.
And Jenkins was happy with the arrangement.
He was bitching at first, but when he saw Casey, he stopped being so picky.
Alright, so... I don't even think it's Jenkins, to be real. But we'll see. I still think it was the set manager. But you will, or whatever. Linda Hamilton, we'll call her that.
Hurry up, please! It burns!
Same tracks. Oh, and there's the hammer. That's what he used, the murder weapon. Look at the blood. Blood type AB matches the sample found in the crime scene. Glasses model matched the one on Jerry Jenkins. Camera lens concealed in the wall. Hidden room detected. Wow, okay. So y'all was making dirty vids in here. Bro, this has always been one of my biggest fears when checking in at like hotels and shit, bro. Why'd you threaten me? Casey, I'm only a doctor. I cannot help with your fee issues. The price of palliative care went up for everyone, not just for your mother. Still, for the money you are paying, there's no one getting as professional care as her. I will remind you that this will end if you tell my wife about us. M. Play the footage. Nope, that's definitely not the woman. It's not Linda. I can't tell if it's the understudy or... Can I talk to him?
So, did you find anything?
According to the evidence, Jenkins is guilty of the murder of Casey Carmel.
I told you!
However, you are guilty of concealing a crime.
Exactly.
Desecration of a corpse. I will call medical assistance. You will be taken in when your condition permits.
Alright, we gotta get Jerry's bitch ass if he's even still there. I thought old girl was trying to set him up.
I can't let you in, Robo. They're in the middle of a shot.
This cannot wait.
They say that 20 seconds in the California sunshine is too much these days. ever since we lost the ozone layer.
I have a solution for you if you are looking for some protection against that California sunshine.
The hell?
A stay in Detroit prison. Gary Jenkins, you are under arrest for the murder of Casey Carmel.
I've seen you on TV. You're glitching again. Ah, it hurts. For fuck's sake, it hurts.
One less dirtbag off the streets. Hard-boiled. Wait, so we can't talk to the little girl? She has nothing to say about what just happened?
Well, that's a wrap.
All right, we came into this area for a reason, bro. We still got to go to the arcade.
Hey, Robo, can you help me out here?
Oh, God.
Pig, why make such a big deal?
How can I assist you, officer?
I'm trying to catch this one shifty dealer. This guy steals nuke from other pushers to sell it at half price. This dopehead buys from him but won't tell me his whereabouts.
I don't know any dealer.
You were carrying for three different pushers, so you either like to walk for miles to buy nuke, or you appreciate a discount.
Don't take it out on me, because the guy broke your nose?
As you can see, he doesn't want to cooperate.
Do not worry. According to my directives, there are several ways to convince him to cooperate.
I ain't gonna let it reprogram my brain. We can talk, but don't let it drill into my head, okay? The guy's name's Maurice, but I don't know where to find him. I always arrange a place over a payphone. I'll give you the number.
Let's hope it works. The dealer knows where the others hide their stash. We could collect nuke from the whole neighborhood if we get to him.
I will take care of it.
But you need to find a payphone first. Try near the supermarket. I think at least one of them hasn't been smashed by vandals yet.
Oh, look, a payphone right here. How convenient.
Oh, this one's broke.
It ain't raining.
Where's the phone booth?
Bag of candies. You never know what you're gonna get.
What?
Is this Maurice?
Listen, man, I'm really swamped with the laundry right now.
Is this Maurice? Too busy to earn some money?
So you would not want to earn some money, would you?
I don't! I mean, I do! I do want to earn money! But wait! Your voice. You sound like...
A future happy customer.
Fucking RoboCop! You want to bust me? Why don't you do a better job of finding guys who vandalize phone booths? I'm losing customers because they can't find working payphone in this goddamn... What the fuck? What the fuck is it this time?
Anybody home? Don't hide, Maurice. It's just a friendly visit. You like to do laundry? You should try working at the laundromat instead of violating the basic rules.
RoboCop, you have to help me! The back of the red building by the supermarket! Apartment 6! There's some guys here! I think they mean business! Hurry!
He's on the phone!
Alright. So we were on the phone with the reasonable dealer. And the angry dealer came in. To cause some shit. We'll find him. We'll get him. If he's not dead already. Apartment 6.
I hear footsteps. If someone starts shooting again, make sure the kids hide under the bed.
Oh, the door's already open. Why is there an arrow? I don't need guidance. Psychoactive substance detected. Nuke. Fisher. More nuke. Where'd they go, though? Nuke. Shoe print of a size 9.5, a trace of the psychoactive substance. Alright, we'll get to it. Damaged phone. This is what he was calling on. Friendly warning. Maurice, I'm writing you because your phone's always busy. But after what you did, I wouldn't want to be seen with you anyway. Suit wouldn't mind you stealing Nuke from those three morons if he got his cut. He gave you the last chance to pay him off, but you screwed it. Now it's too late, so you better change your address. I can assure you that your excuses won't work with the Torch Edge. They're crazy. Maurice's laundry schedule. Alright. Girl's footprints at. Where'd they go?
Listen, guys, I'll never touch your stuff again, I swear!
That's not why we're here.
So what do you want? The money? I have your money.
He said the money?
You only have half of it, and that's the problem. You're selling our product at half price. That makes my customers complain about my prices.
It ain't nice, Maurice!
Maybe you think that building a customer base by selling your product under its manufacturing cost is a good idea.
Under what?
But it's not. Such practices are spoiling the market.
It's been proven time and time again that such action leads to a reduction of future demand, yours included. Antitrust laws are there for a reason.
Shit, Maurice! All we want to say is that you violate the basic rules of the market with your predatory pricing. We can't just go along with that.
It's unfair and unethical.
Not to mention illegal.
The fuck?
You are under arrest. Come quietly, or this may be the last economics discussion you will ever have.
Get him!
So y'all just stood there.
Man, why did you do that? What am I gonna sell now?
There are serious charges against you, Maurice. However, you can hope for a reduced sentence if you reveal where these three dealers keep their drugs.
Or I can jump into that pile of garbage below. A few bruises is better than jail.
Do you know what the likelihood is of surviving that?
I know the hood better than you do, cop. So try some different talk, or I'll jump.
Soot is looking for you.
Even if you escape, Soot is out to get you. You will be safer in prison.
I missed our meeting. I was busy, but he doesn't get that. Doing laundry is important to me. It relaxes me.
If you cooperate, you can get a job at the prison laundry.
You mean I eat and live for free? And I do what I like to do anyway? I feel like I won the lottery, man!
Yo, these criminals.
I'll tell you where these jerks kept this stuff.
These criminals, man.
But
they're
killing me.
I have
to have
our
deal in writing.
Enjoy doing laundry, Maurice. Alright, now let's get to this arcade, finally. Hopefully no one calls us aside, you know, on our way there. They're really, like, you know, painting the home, like, man, it's so bad out here. A lot of these guys would rather just be inside than, you know, having to deal with the streets.
You piece of shit.
I mean, we've seen the movies. It's like a war zone out there.
Bored with harassing successful entrepreneurs.
Hey, this shit is rigged.
That's a serious accusation, kiddo. Someone might think I would allow such illegal activity in my high-class business, which I do not. I get lost.
You work for Soot. Tell me where to find him.
You cops are giving me a stomach ulcer. Stop asking me about guys I don't know.
Withholding information can lead to bigger trouble than a stomach ulcer.
Look, I'm a busy man, so I'm going back to my office now. Why don't you join me there, and we'll talk. Oh, on second thought, you can't do that, because you don't have a warrant, do you?
What a douchebag.
I like how he's like, yeah, I don't know anything about no Soot. Then he opens the door and a torch head lets him in.
Have you witnessed the owner participating in any criminal activity?
Are you kidding me? Half the things I've seen around here would be enough to put him behind bars for a decade.
Let us hear your statement.
No way, dude. He might be a douchebag, but if you lock him up, this place will get closed down, and where am I supposed to play hooky then?
Children should not skip school. It is important for them to attend every single class.
I stopped listening after should.
Enter the basement. Knock. Is that all I have to do? That's funny. Damn, that little kid been gaming.
Colors, and there's not one but two of you. From now on, I promise I will cherish you more often.
Why are you just sitting on the toilet, my guy? Oh, he has a nuke
in
his system.
Suggest substance misuse.
Oh man, a real like TJ Laser? You are so incredibly shiny. I'm definitely getting more of this stuff.
Who sold you drugs?
I really shouldn't say, but. You are my TV hero, so... Alright, all of the arcade staff will sell to you. As long as you got cash. Unfortunately, I'm broke. But I have a great idea. You could help me sneak into the basement. They keep a huge stash of goodies down there.
You know what? You might be onto something.
I will take care of that.
What Would you really do that for me? Way to go, TJ!
Search warrant granted.
Is that the ocean?
I'm a fucking baked.
Open the door. I have the warrant.
Oopsie. I think I dropped my key somewhere. You'd have to break down this hardened door if you want to get in.
That will not be a problem.
Ha ha! Yo! I love it, bro. I love it. I'm sorry if that was loud. That motherfucker went fly.
It's RoboCop!
It's me.
Surrender your weapons.
Yes. Light him up!
Look at this guy. That was so fucking funny. That will not be a problem. I don't want to pick up no damn pistol. Stolen jewelry. Micro SMG. That's the one right there. But I feel like there's a trophy for probably using all the weapons in the game. So let me pick up the pistol. My little pea shooter. Oh shit.
He's coming.
Hold on, this pistol kinda... Where'd you go, sir? Is he in here? Oh, there's a lot more of them. Bro, what is going on? How did he throw it that far? Keeps making me want to pick chairs up, bro. I don't got any OCP charges. Say nuke or get lost. Tell the buyers to stop using made up names for nuke. None of this double cheese auntie and hot sauce, body bags, and red fucking whatever. It only makes my guys confused, and that's bad for business. Pigs can't do shit, for there's no need to speak in the code. These dope heads either buy nuke or jack all. Your lovely superstardom boss, S. Is that the new guy in town? Is S the big guy? Stolen purse. Yeah, I keep thinking it's evidence, but it's just chairs to pick up and throw at dirt bags. Locked.
Open the door or you will regret it.
Can a guy just sell drugs to kids without you harassing him every 5 minutes? Who am I hurting, huh? They all want it.
The children.
Where do I find
Well, if that's the case, shut it, bozo. Unless you want to end up in the ghost house like that cop's informant.
And don't you dare open that door. I'll shoot you.
Have it your way.
Thank you. Yeah, the breaching, it needs a little bit of work. Secret button activates connected device. What's connected? Find this wall. Oh, there's a safe. Engineering level 6. It was worth a try. I already knew I wasn't. What do we have here? In front of the ghost house? Call note. Too many cops patrolling the place. Don't leave before the police informant talks. Suits order. Detox made the snitch too weak. Use tainted nuke to crank him up. Ghost house. Down the street next to the train tracks. Got it. Got it. What else? No recorded messages. Installation invoice. $62 desk button. 2300 armored gate. $580 installation. All right, let's press the button on this desk. What did that open? Oh, there's a safe code. Huh? How am I going to figure that out? Oh, deduction level 2 required? Can I do that right now? We can do it. Oh, it has to be level 2. Dang it, I'm about to level up again, too. What did that button open up? Leave the arcade.
Murphy, this is Reed. Mayor Kuzak just stormed into my office. Apparently, his niece's car has been stolen. Find it. This goes to the top of your priority list. You can start by asking about it at some of the local garages. For the record, it's a blue SUX 6000 registered to Melissa Kuzak.
You know, nah, we gonna that's gonna wait. We found the ghost house. Find the police informant.
Oh shit! It's a metal freak. You need to be taught some manners.
Almost definitely going back to the arcade and opening that safe.
It's a
shit. Who's shooting? You felt it, didn't ya? The hell? Oh. Inside we go. Finally. Anything in here? Contraband? Oh, I see the vision. The last guy. What? RoboCop doesn't take fall damage, okay? You're gonna fry. Oh, is he up here somewhere? Yeah, I'm gonna need to level up deduction right now. That's pretty useful. Good to know he doesn't take fall damage. Yeah, oh shit is right. Oh, you're hiding? Alright, cool. Gives me time to look what's up in here. And the answer is not a damn thing.
simple enough. Terminating pictures. Where does this lead to? Oh, is this the exit? This is the way out? For sure. Alright. Open.
Are you the police informant? Do you know where I can find Soot?
Oh man, all great questions, but could you untie me first? They really outdid themselves with these knots.
Talk.
Hey, I don't know how you usually operate, but that type of information don't come free.
What is your freedom worth to you?
That's actually a great point. So, it seems that the new guy saw the punks attack on the TV station and decided to meet with Soot on their turf. The meeting is supposed to take place tonight during Soot's concert.
Concert?
I know. I'm not really a fan of his music myself. But that's not what those shows are really about. Why don't we, get out of here, huh?
Lewis. Soot is meeting the new guy tonight at the old slaughterhouse.
Copy that. Pick me up at the station. I'll grab my gear. By the way,
upgrade chips.
I've got something for you, Murphy.
They call me Pickles. And you guessed it. There's a funny story behind that name. This one time, I saw Torchhead stealing a delivery truck. I went after them, hoping that a VCR would fall off the back of the truck, you know? But it turned out to be groceries. So they left it. I made a pretty penny that day selling pickles.
Are you following me, sir? Hurry up.
Jars laying around if you want them.
So you are an opportunist.
Hey, I prefer.
Give me your whole life story about pickles.
Know what they say? Good business is where you find it.
Hurry up. Why was you creeping up like that, bro? You ain't getting away from me. Someone's gonna attack us.
Ah, it's nice to be free again. Thanks, Tin Man. Hey, did Briggs tip you off that I might be here?
Officer Briggs?
Yeah, he's my police go-to guy.
Officer Briggs is missing.
Missing? Shit. May our city have mercy on him.
How about joining the force?
You seem proficient in undertaking police tasks. Ever thought of making a living out of it?
Oh, no. One thing you should know about me. I love cops, you know, law enforcement, laws, all of that. I think those are great ideas. But so is Nuke, and when I need it, I tend to forget about the other stuff. So, you know what they say, you can only serve one master.
How do you know Officer Briggs?
We go back a long way. He gave me a helping hand when I hit rock bottom, and I've been in his debt ever since. He even introduced me to his family. Great kid and wife, though. His missus don't seem very fond of me.
He doesn't seem like too bad of a guy, you know.
Do you think Briggs is in trouble?
I really don't know. Last time I saw him, he was going to check a case of missing bodies. Sounded like a bogus lead, so I didn't press him. Funny enough, he always tells me to be careful when getting info. But the truth is, I'm not the one running around Gangster's Paradise dressed in blue.
Need to go. Duty awaits.
About that, I've got a favor to ask. I know that Briggs is missing, but I've got something that belongs to him. He must have misplaced it the last time he visited my crib, and it's kind of weighing me down.
What is it?
It's his wristwatch. Now, I feel bad holding on to it. Could you please give it back to his family?
This is stolen property, and you expect me to return it?
Gee, that sounds bad when you say it like that, but still, you shouldn't let me hold on to expensive things. That's how I ended up in this situation in the first place.
I will make sure they receive it from the repentant thief.
Oh, boy. You're a tough negotiator. But surely you don't mean now. I gotta chillax after all this.
Let us go now. Let us meet there later. Oh yeah, because I still gotta go to the arcade and unlock that safe.
I have more urgent matters on hand. Meet me later at Briggs' place.
Yeah, you gotta save the city. That's fine by me. I'll see you later.
Drive to the old slaughterhouse. Or we can go to Briggs right now. Alright, y'all, I'm gonna end it right here. Had a lot of fun with this. This game is dope. I wonder how long it is. You know, I hope it's a, you know, decent sized game. But that was fun. Can't wait to finish it up. Can't wait to run through it. Clean up these streets. Alright, y'all. Y'all have a good one.